What's up, everybody? Chris Sim Walker from Legiit here, back with part, I want to say, four of our AI plus Legiit case study that we've been doing. In today's video, what we're going to do is take a look at the content that was done on the site, the IFTTT that we got delivered, and the indexing status, and then we're going to talk about some next steps that we're going to take. And that's pretty much it. Let's dive over in the computer and get into it. All right, if you've been following along, you know that this is the site we've been using, boxingtribune-news.com. Now, if you haven't, just check the description and the first comment. Everything, the rest of the series will be linked there along with any of the other resources that we've had. And if you take a look, the site is now filled out with content. There's not a ton left to do on the site in that regard. The only thing I need to do is, where is it? There's some lorem ipsum there I still need to clean up, and I think on this page as well. Yeah, I have to just clean up some of the placeholder text in a couple spots, but overall I think it's ready to go, and the logo doesn't make a lot of sense, but who cares. So that's that. And if you want to take a look here in the back end, we will come over to posts. And you can see we have 1,019 posts now. So we're going to talk about that in a minute. But one other thing I want to show you that I did is this. If you come over to pages, and I'm not completely done doing this just yet, but where is it? I made it this page and this page. And the reason I did that is, let me log into Ahrefs real quick. So the reason that I did that is if you come over here and you look at the backlinks to the site, and you sort them by DR, some of the best ones were linked, and I haven't completely finished this yet, but for example, this one was a link from Wikipedia, which is one of the reasons that I chose this domain, and it was linking to this URL, and what I did was I recreated that URL so that link still exists and it won't eventually get dropped off. Now it may anyway, but I can't control that, but I very much increase the chances of that. And then there was a second one that was this one that for some reason I can only see Ahrefs doesn't see it. I only see it in SEMrush, which is unusual, but you can see right there it's got a link from Forbes. And now I know this is like a blog version of Forbes or something like that, but that's another link too. So the whole point in that was to recreate pages that have important backlinks going to them. Now you obviously won't do that for every link, but I do like to go and find significant links that I'd like to keep. Like I will recreate this post as well and so on. So I do that just, I'm showing you this to show you everything that we do because this is a case study and who knows if it's even going to work, but I want to take advantage of the most powerful links that that's getting. Now, when we get down in here into these that aren't so great, I probably won't bother with that. Actually, I might with that one because that's a pretty good relevant link. But overall, I only do that with like really important links, like this Wikipedia link that I'd like hope to be able to keep, or that Forbes link, which I'm really surprised that Ahrefs doesn't pick that up. That's interesting. But anyhow, that's why I did that. So that's that. So let's close these out so we get less cluttered. And as far as the content, I don't necessarily advise that you do this, but I just went into archive.org and I just copied what the page looked like back then in more hopes that it will stay the way it is. Now, technically, that's using somebody else's content and you don't want to do that, but you know. And then I also link back to the home page on these pages to just kind of give it that little extra authority. So that's just one thing I wanted to show you in addition to what we did what I did that worked, basically. So the other things that we did were we created, and let's go over to the content first. We used this service, Build GPT-3 AI Automated Blogging on Your Niche. And he did it. I mean, I don't really have a lot to show here, but let's just take a quick look at this. And as you can see, these are the posts that he made, you know, and along with the volume. So some of these, and he even broke them down into category. Now, some of these may be pretty easy to pick off. Who knows? So that's pretty much that service. There's not a lot to say about that, but these are the posts. Now let's go ahead and take a look at some of the posts. Obviously, we're not going to look at all of them, but I think they come out pretty good. Like, what is a cross inboxing? Let's take a look at the page. Nice little image there. It's nothing mind-blowing, but you see it even has a, I think these are called Johnson boxes. Forgive me if that's wrong. But you can see there's pretty, you know, realistic looking content, for lack of a better term. I'm just going to pick a handful of them at random. Like this, I've seen like actual human-made blogs that don't look as good as this. So I'm pleased with what I got here. And let's, how to get rid of sore muscles. Lord knows I could use that some days. So overall, I'm pleased with how it turned out. And let's take a look at the indexing while we're at it. You know, earlier it was in the 60s. That's interesting. But right now we have 43 pages indexed, which, you know, is not a ton considering it's 1,000, but considering it's only been 2 days since he started posting the content, that's pretty good progress, I'd say. So there's no sandbox or anything like that going on. So that's good. And we're going to come back to indexing in just a few minutes. But I also want to take a look at this one, which was the IFTTT ring. So I'm going to go ahead and download the deliverable. So as you can see, this is the deliverable from that. Now, I have removed the email and the username and the password because, you know, obviously, for obvious reasons, at least I hope it's obvious. But somebody in the comments was asking about this and they didn't understand how this works. So basically, and it probably didn't fire for all of them, but basically whenever this makes a post, it will syndicate out to these other properties and kind of build links back to the site. So let's take a look at one of them. And I haven't looked at this. It may not have fired because sometimes IFTTT gets overwhelmed. Yeah, but you can see the Blogspot made at least one of the posts, or at least a handful of them. So it's just built a way to build some links back to your site naturally as it progresses. And this will help with indexing and a little bit with SEO, not a ton, and stuff like that. Let's take a look at, where is it, Instapaper. So it'd be nice, back in the day you could do this and it would fire off all 1,000 of them, but they had to rate limit it, like Twitter. So, you know, unfortunately it only made one here, but I think you get the idea, right? It's just a way to syndicate out to do that. You don't really have to do this step, but I figured it'd be just a little extra help. And I think that's part of the reason that we're already seeing some indexing going on. As you can see in this one, it grabbed several of the posts and moved them over to here too. I would have preferred it only do an excerpt. It seems like it did the whole thing. That's probably because of the AI content or something, but I don't know, you get the idea. It's just a way to build some natural links that somebody would do if they were running a blog. So that's what that did. Now, the next thing I want to do is help the indexing along. So what I'm gonna do is come up to the dashboard, and I used a plugin called Export Post Info. And what that does is it just exports some info about the post. And I'm just gonna grab 100 or so of these. And what we're gonna do is come over here to, where is it? Instant indexing. And we're going to paste in those 100. And we're going to send to the API. And then I'm not going to do this all on camera, but I'm going to go ahead and submit all of them like that over the next couple of days to try to get more posts indexed if possible. Once I've done all of them, I'll give it another day or two and see how many are indexed and take whatever's left and use this service to do the rest of the indexing. This service here to do the rest, whatever's left of the indexing. And I know that I taught him how to do this. I know how he's doing it. I know it works. And he's kind of become like the go-to guy for indexing. So yeah, that's that. Another thing that I'm gonna do is, where did the site go? So we're going to use another plugin called Link Whisper. It's been a while since I installed this. I hope it's not one that okay, good. So this is a plugin called Link Whisper, which is used to create internal links between posts, which on a site this big is going to be really, really key to help with the ranking. I'm not going to go into the entire thing on this particular video because to be perfectly honest, it's been a while since I did it and I'd have to like muddle my way through it. But what I will do is record it and put that into a separate video so you can see it. But basically what it's going to do is it's going to go through and find contextual places to link from one post to the other, to the other, to the other, to the other, and so on. So that's pretty much that. So that's, like I said, I'll do that in a separate video and have that out soon. So that way you can kind of see how that works too. It'll be overkill for a video like this, but that's pretty much that. Let's take a look ranking. I don't think there's a ton that's ranking just yet. I think it's just a couple of branded keywords, but let's take a look. I don't know about anybody else, but I find in general SEMrush to be a better tool for finding keyword data than is Ahrefs, but your mileage may vary. Interesting. I'm gonna have to go back and look at the historic data and see what keywords and what pages were ranking back then. And I'll make a separate video on that too and try to recreate those too and see if we can't pick that back up. Who knows if it'll work, but okay. So here it says that we're ranking for one page, how to dry boxing gloves, and it's way down on position 86. So that's nothing too spectacular, but that's a page that was just created a day ago. So, you know, that's something. It's nothing to get too excited about, but you know, we're still blending the site index. So we're going to go to Ahrefs and it shows two keywords. And I believe these were the two branded ones. Yeah. So the Boxing Tribune, that's page 2, and Boxing Tribune also page 2. And it's the category page that's ranking, which is interesting. So I may have to tweak that a little bit to try to get that to do what I want it to do, but theirs is notoriously slow at updating. So hopefully in a few days that will pick up too. So that's pretty much where we are on that. So just to recap real quick what we've done and wrap this video up, we built out 1,000 posts on our site, which I think looks pretty good for a site that I paid less than $100 to get designed using this service, Basic. Well, I don't know if I used the Basic, but I built 1,000 posts for $600. You don't have to do near that many, but that's what I did. They came out looking, in my opinion, pretty good. We used IFTTT to syndicate those out to some blog spots and some Weeblies and some other things to help with the indexing and things like that. Let's look at an incognito window. We have 43 pages indexed so far. Some of them are the categories, but some of them are regular posts. And we're going to try to get more of them indexed. To try to get more of them indexed, we're using the instant indexing thing here. And to try to get more of them indexed, we're using the Rank Math plugin to do instant indexing, which I set up a while back. And if that doesn't work, we're going to use this service to do the rest of them or get as many of them indexed as we possibly can. Then we are going to use the Link Whisper plugin to run a link scan and build internal links throughout all the posts. Now, I'm going to record that, but I'm not going to be as precise as I would be, but since this is a massive project, but that's that. And that's pretty much it. The next steps after that will be to, once we get a significant number of pages ranking and the site builds up some authority, then we're going to go ahead and we get the internal linking done. We're going to submit it to Search Console to get it crawled even more. Then we'll start tracking our rankings and seeing how that's going. And once we start to see some progress with rankings, then we're going to do some backlinks to really fire this thing along. And then we'll get into monetization. So that's where we are with this right now. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. I'm going to respond to them. If I see them, I respond to as many of them as I possibly can. And that's that. So I hope you're enjoying this. I know I certainly am. And I'm looking forward to making this take off and see how it goes. So I'll leave links to everything that I've discussed here in the comments as well. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, I'm here for you. Thanks for watching. I know you could be doing anything else, and you're here watching this, so I appreciate that. I'll see you again soon. Peace.